500. Use your credit card to avoid COD charges, or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $3 shipping and handling to the Gutbusters.
Hey, we're getting done over there, I can tell you. We're sending brother off to military school next
year. WPBT, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, and the Palm Beaches.
Canella Fitzgerald tell whether Tom Waits and Ricky Lee Jones' rendition of Edward Albee's Zoo Story is live or on Mamorex video cassette tapes?
I said, have you been to the zoo?
One more time, baby.
I said, have you been to the zoo?
You're talking to me, right?
Mamorex video cassette tapes made with the finest Filipino mylar money can buy.
I said, man, have you been to the zoo?
I've been to the zoo.
I said, have you... It's been really fine working with you.
Hey, too much.
That's live. That's live. That's tape. That's live. But that's live. That's... I'm tape. That's live.
Mamorex video cassette tapes. So real, even Ella Fitzgerald can't tell.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin. Rick Moranis, Dave Thomas, featuring Robin Duke and Tony Rosato. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network.
SCTV now begins its programming day with Sunrise Semester. Today's topic, basic photography with Edith Prickley.
Oh, hello. Just loading my camera. Well, today we're going to learn the technique behind great passport photography. Why do they always have to make you look so damn ugly? I always end up looking like Ma Kettle. Well, I'm here to tell you you can look glamorous as well as official. You just have to follow the easy prickly formula. In a moment, I'm going to be using my cousin Shirley as a model. She's planning a trip to London on one of those cheap Laker flights. Of course, she has to bring her own tuna sandwich. So I said to her, Cheryl, I'll save you a few bucks, make you look gorgeous, we'll have a party at the same time. Here we go. What makes this passport picture look so damn good? It's not the camera. It's not the light. It's not even the puss on this little gal. It's the mood the photographer creates. And that's the secret of all those high-fashion photographers. Scavullo, Avedon, Karsh. And now Prickley. They know how to relax their models by creating the perfect mood. So why don't we begin with the beginning? My cousin Shirley.
Hello, Edith.
Loosen up, honey. It's a passport picture, not a morgue shot. See, you got a head start in the Chablis.
Well, I did.
Finish the bottle.
Don't mind if I do.
That's number one. Relax your subject with a good, stiff drink. Then you're ready to begin. Now, number two is music. Not just any kind of music. We're talking mood music. We're talking music with a beat. We're talking music you can move to. We're talking bar talk. Roll it, boys. I hear it. I got it. Make it move. Go, Shirley. Yeah. Start, baby. Go, Shirley. Down, Shirley. Let go, Shirley. There we go. Make it happen. Look at me, Shirley. There we go. We've got it, Shirley. Down there. Up there. Go. The important thing is to always keep your model moving so she stays alert. Now for some close-ups. Let me look at you, sweetheart. Did you fall into a bucket of chalk or am I going blind? We gotta help that little mug along with a little mood lighting. We're talking umbrella light. Shirley? Here we are, Shirley. Alan Bates is on you, Shirley. He loves you. He's coming in, Shirley. Do it. You're gorgeous. You're beautiful. We got it. Now for number three. The prickly formula, the piece de resistance, the secret of all those top fashion photographers. Bring it in, boys, and turn it on! I think we got it. Here we are. Scavullo, eat your heart out. So, what did you learn today on the prickly formula? WMF. Wine, music, fan. Your ticket to perfect passport pictures. Where'd you hear it from? You heard it from Prickly. Next week, we're going to learn how to take candid shots of the hubby at home. Playgirl's offering $50 a pic. So tune in, you could get rich. Bye now from the eyes of Edith Prickly.
You're through with that, Edith?
Yes, I am, honey. You are hot out there. Lauren Hutton.
Everybody's favorite talk show producer is back, this time with his own show.
Bobby, where are you going to be appearing next week? Where are you going to be appearing next week?
Oh, I'll be at home, my man.
Every week, the finest and the funniest from Hollywood go head-to-head with the talk show king.
And, Bubbles, where will you be appearing next week?
I'm sorry, pretty kid.
I said, where will you be appearing, Bubbles?
Oh, appearing?
Next week.
Oh, I'll be at Carnegie Hall, and then after that, I'm going to be down at Caesar's Palace.
I say that's funny. Well, that's all the time we have for tonight. Thanks for stopping by.
Dear.
Thanks for stopping by.
Oh.
What's the time?
The Freddie de Cordova Show, Thursday at 9 on SCTV.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Guy Caballero. Caballero's the name. Owning SCTV's the game. I'm owner and president. Don't you ever forget it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're proud to be presenting fine programming to you via the SCTV satellite. That's right. We feel our satellite's the best in the whole world, and we're bringing you programming from all over the world. And tonight is no exception. Tonight, we're bringing to you live from Turkey. That's right, Turkey. The great country of Turkey. It's not that small. It's a wonderful country. It's beaming up a show to us, and we're bringing you a show from Turkey. It's presented from our sister station there. It's from Istanbul. I think it's called ITV. But it's a wonderful program, and it's got music and laughs and Turks and everything you'd ever want in a show. And all we need is money from you to keep this satellite up in the air. And I'd appreciate it if you could start sending money in, because we need it desperately. We're talking not peanuts here, but we're talking $10,000 per person. That's right. We need a lot of money. $10,000 isn't that much. Believe me, you'd probably just be buying a couple of cars with it or something. So why don't you put it to good use and see these fine programs? We got one coming from Kuimoi and Matsu. They banded together. Next week, we'll have that on. But only if you can send in that money. $10,000 a person. It's not asking too much. Please. Now, for that fine program from Turkey. With music and laughs and Turks galore. And it's not going to be a turkey, either. You're probably thinking that out there, aren't you? Well, it's not.
Well, time here in Turkey, Lou, but remember one thing. They have strange laws over here, strange customs. I don't want you getting us into any trouble.
Oh, you don't have to worry about me, Buzz.
You can't fool around over here.
I won't fool around.
I don't want you talking to any strangers.
Don't worry about me. I won't talk to anybody. I don't even know any strangers.
Well, just make sure you don't.
My lips are sealed. I won't say a word.
Not a word. Remember that.
All right, I'll remember. I promise.
Hey, man.
Yes, sir. Can I help you?
Can you take this package for me? I'm overweight bag. It's a cake for my grandmother.
You're giving a cake to your grandmother? Well, all right, but I can't say anything to anybody, so don't talk to me.
Thanks, man.
Hey, don't say nothing to me. I won't say nothing to you. My friend Buzz thinks I haven't got any brains, but I've got brains I haven't even used yet.
Don't let it go to your head.
All right.
Hey, where'd you get that package?
Oh, a fella gave it to me.
What fella?
This fella right behind
me. There's nobody there.
Well, he was here a minute ago.
Didn't I tell you not to talk to anybody?
Oh, honest, Buzz, I didn't say anything to anybody. He just gave me this cake to give to his grandmother.
You, what's in the box?
I'm sorry, I can't talk to anybody.
Answer the man.
I said, what's in the box?
This fellow behind me just gave me a cake to give to his dear grandmother.
Open the box.
You want me to open up somebody else's box? I don't think so.
Open the box for the man.
I was just going to. Oh, must be a small granny, Buzz. Look at the size of these cakes.
This is hashish.
Hashish?
Hashish?
What's the matter with you? Trying to smuggle dope across the border? Who's this?
This is my friend, Buzz.
I've never seen this man before in my life.
You're both under arrest. Seize them.
Seize them? I seize them. He's right here.
Cut it out. We're in enough trouble already. Oh, great.
Istanbul, Turkey. It's the Midnight Express Special. Starring the band John Denver and Murray, Randy Newman, and tonight's special hosts, Abbott and Costello.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You know, Lou and I were thrilled when they asked us to host the Midnight Express special here in Istanbul. Now, Lou, this is your first trip to Europe, isn't it?
Yes, it is, Buzz.
You like Turkey?
Oh, you know me, I love Turkey. I love Turkey with stuffing and gravy on the side. I'd love
Turkey, Turkey, the country.
Well, I wouldn't call it a turkey, Buzz. We've only been here a couple of minutes.
Oh, cut it out.
Off we will.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a great show for you tonight. Our first group is making their big comeback on the show tonight. So, Lou, why don't you introduce the band?
You want me to introduce the band?
That's right.
All right, I'll introduce the band. What band?
The band.
What's the name of the band?
I'm telling you, man, the band.
Well, who's the band?
No. Who's on next week?
What are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you, who's on next week?
Well, what do I care who's on next week? If I'm going to introduce the band tonight, I got to know their name.
That is their name.
That's whose name?
The band. What's the matter with you?
Look, are you the fellow who booked the band?
That's right.
Well, who's the band?
Who's on next week?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Well, I'm telling you.
Look, have you signed a contract with the band?
That's right.
Was the band's name on it?
Absolutely. Well, it's no good unless they sign it.
It's no good unless who signed it?
The band.
Well, who signed it?
Who's on next week?
I don't care who. Who's on next week? I gotta know the name of the band that's on tonight.
Are you listening to me? The band is on tonight. Who's on next week? You follow me?
Yes.
No. Yes said no. They were booked.
Who's booked?
Didn't I just say who's on next week?
Yes.
No. They're booked.
Who's booked?
Yes.
Look, let me get this straight. Yes is booked. Who's on next week? And the band is on tonight?
Well, that's the first sensible thing you've said.
I don't even know what I'm talking about. And frankly, I don't give a darn because this is for the birds.
What did you just say?
I said this is for the birds.
They broke up long ago. Now, look, forget the band. They probably packed up and gotten home by now. You took so long.
Well, I don't blame them. A band without a name is certainly not going to go anywhere.
Just introduce John Denver.
John Denver? Well, at least he's got a name. Here's John Denver.
That'll teach him. And let that be a lesson to all you kids. When you travel over here, keep your dope at home. Because when you get busted for dope over here, you're in for the hassle of your life. Right, Yusuf?
Yeah, hassle.
All right. Now, here's a lady who begged us to bring her over here to Turkey just so she could get out of Canada. Here's Anne Murray.
Beneath its snowy metal folded wings, the unborn grass lies waiting for its coat to turn to green. The snowbird sings a song he always sings and speaks to me of flowers that will bloom again in spring.
Hey, what is this? Miss Lewis!
bird was now a jailbird. Which reminds me, don't mess up your head with dope.
Abbott and Costello will return on the Midnight Express special right after this.
Now, once again, here's Abbott and Costello.
Abbott and Costello.
Lou, wasn't it nice of Hillary to pay us that visit?
Very nice of Hillary. She's a very nice girl.
She's very fond of you.
Oh, she likes me a lot, I think. She packed me a lunch and gave me a whole bunch of chocolate bars.
Chocolate bars? You didn't mention anything about chocolate bars. What, are you hiding them from me?
No, Hillary gave them to me, not you.
Well, isn't that a fine remark coming from you? Me, your lifelong pal, your bosom buddy, and you won't give me a chocolate bar.
I'm sorry, Buzz. I didn't mean it that way.
Of course you meant it that way. After all I've done for you. When we were 5 months behind in our rent, who did I let pay the rent?
Me.
You.
Nice of you then.
And when I got a ticket for speeding and I couldn't afford the ticket, who went to jail?
Me.
You. Always thinking of yourself.
I forget things so fast. Something bad.
Oh. You're a bad boy, all right.
Look, Buzz, why don't you have the rest of the bar, Buzz? I only took a bite out of it. You can have it all.
That's more like it.
Good, huh?
Say, this isn't chocolate, Lou.
What do you mean this isn't chocolate? Well, if this isn't chocolate, then...
Don't say it. Don't say that word. Lou, this is hashish.
This is hashish?
I told you not to say that word, didn't I? What's the matter with you? It's a fine way to carry on. I can let go of my coat.
I just ate two bars.
You just ate them? Oh, for heaven's sake. Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Newman.
Istanbul, Turkey. The Midnight Express special has reached its destination. We want to thank all of you for having been aboard this evening. And now, a special good night from our extra special hosts, Abbott and Costello.
Well, Lou, I hope you're happy. Thanks to me, we're finally getting out of here.
Well, I gotta hand it to you, Buzz. It was certainly smooth the way you talked to that guard, giving him all my money like that.
What are you eating?
Well, I've had this real appetite ever since I had those two chocolate bars.
Put it away. You trying to get us into trouble again?
All right. Don't worry. I won't say a word to anybody no more.
Well, make sure you don't. Shut up.
I didn't say anything.
Well, that's just in case you do.
Excuse me. Is this the line for flight 357? It is? Oh, have you been waiting long? Say, you're kind of cute. Oh, what, half on your tongue? Listen, why don't you save a seat on the plane for you and me? Oh, by the way, would you mind carrying this parcel for me while I go and powder my nose? Thanks,
Package.
The lady behind me just gave it to
well,
me.
Well, put it away.
If you take it, Bud, please, I don't want
it. I don't want it.
Anything to declare? Pet boy, open the shirt.
You want me to open my shirt? I don't even know you.
Open your shirt for the man.
Right. I think he thinks I'm a dope smuggler. You boys want a lollipop?
What about the package?
That's his.
That's not my package. Some lady gave it to him.
Don't lie to the man, Abbott.
What's in there is what I think's in there. We're in big trouble again.
Don't worry, Buzz. It's just more of those chocolate bars that Hillary's
eating. Step this way, please.
I did it again, Buzz.
You certainly did. For
heaven's sake. Watch the jacket. Watch the jacket.
You get over here. What's the matter with you? Get up over here and stand right there.
Watch it.
Don't give these guys a hard time.
I'm not. They're giving me a hard time.
They're just doing their job.
I'll give them a job.
Hey,
believe in the hashish?
I don't know anything about any hashish. Maybe this will refresh your memory. That doesn't scare me.
No, huh?
Then how about this? Why don't you go fly a kite? Fly a kite, huh?
Maybe the small fat one knows something.
Maybe he does, huh? Maybe the small fat one knows something, huh?
All right. Where did you get the hashish?
Would you mind just waiting for 1 minute, please? Get ready, Buzz. Why don't you go fly a kite?
Inspector, I found this woman in the washroom attempting to hide some ashes.
Ah, so she's the one, huh? Get out. Move. Now's our chance to get out of here. Come on, let's go.
I certainly did, Buzz.
When you mess around with dope over here...
You're in for the hassle of your life.
Say good night.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everybody.
Coming soon, bringing a disaster theme to the talk show scene. It's the Irwin Allen Show. With special guest, Shelley Winters.
The train runs on fire. It's the most horrible thing I've seen in my life.
Red Button.
That's the closest I ever came to getting a roast to this business.
And Charlton Heston.
It's a remarkable film, actually.
The Irwin Allen Show. Watch out for it.
Can America's space program ever get off the ground again? Tomorrow at 8, NOVA looks at the cost of our recent inability to provide service to space-based interests. Also look at the long line of missions that have been put on indefinite hold following the space shuttle disaster. Walk the rocky road to Jupiter tomorrow at 8 on NOVA.
People often ask, what makes WPBT so good? It's not a mystery. The answer is really very simple. Member support. As a public television station, we receive over 50% of our support